welcome, and since we've had people especially turn up for the experience of singing in the, you know, we'll get underway for you. This is the first song. This is the With or Without You from You Two. And Evan will sing it and we will be accompanying him in this way. And Little poem.
Ladies and gentlemen, trouble when you live in a family full of watchmakers. You end up not having a watch that's the right time. It's a bit like a mechanic that has a car that's not the best in the community. But I think we're nearly ready at the moment, and I'd like us now to formally welcome Jody O'Regan and the sublime voices. If you'd like to make a few welcome, thank you.
Go to sleep, little baby. Go to sleep, little baby.
Sleep, little baby.
music, which is actually very, very good for what we would think of today as a serial murderer. So we hope you enjoy it. It's him telling a story about what he thinks about friends. He likes them, but Mr. Pius is having a few problems.
Still is writing a lot of music. He's written some grand musicals. One two guys out of Barrow. And the musical was called Chess. And the storyline surrounds a chess competition, with the two protagonists mainly being an American fellow and a Russian chess master who, in fact, had defected from the USSR. And this is taken out of that musical. It's called Anthem.
See you. us today. Just a beautiful little love song.
Station Road overlooking the 12th Apostle, sounds crazy, cliffs above the sea. It was a sunny summer Sunday on a cliff cut by the sea. I'd made myself a picnic lunch, some sandwiches and tea. I'd been there half an hour when I heard a kind of moan. And gradually it came to me that I was not alone. He was hanging by his fingers from the edge of the abyss. He'd been there quite some time. Now let me tell you this. When it comes to cliff-top picnics, I find it pays to be particular. Always choose the horizontal part, never the perpendicular. I can see he'd lost his tablecloth. And his condiments as well. His teapot too was missing. He was upset, I could tell. Now there was no long preamble, no extended peroration. He limited himself to hell by way of conversation. Now it's a very English thing that as he hung by his fingers above the sea, I said to him, "Would you like a cup of tea?" I poured him out a cup. And he was so elated he took it straight away. Perhaps it's too late. He clung on with his left hand. In his right, a cup of tea. His options were quite limited. His fate was up to me. And given his position, my next move was not a smart one. I said to him, "You take milk." Handed him the cup. I was afraid he punched a certain death so far beneath. But as he passed an overhanging branch, he clung onto it with his teeth. In his left hand, still no. In the right, still no. I leaned forward over the cliff. I looked down. Hey, look, look. When they asked me, was it my fault? I felt a great hurry. I called out, "You take sugar!" And he looked up and said, "Yes, please!"
Somewhere morning, where
third year of coming up to the Barossa, and we come up for Pentecost. So we're singing at the Anguston United Church tomorrow morning for a combined uniting and Anglican service. And this is one of the songs we'll be singing.
Oh, course, however, we thought, well, let's not just talk about what's in the newspaper and on the TV. Let's try and make it a bit more interesting than it usually is. So we thought, well, the musical version might be good. And those of you who are familiar with Anglican liturgical practice might also recognise something with which you're a little familiar. So I haven't told you what it is. So we're going to find out.
Thank you.
bit of country and western now, that choral style, the Eagle Seven Bridges Road.
Oh. so I'd just like to preface my remarks by saying that normally Steve, as Mr. Stephen Page, will be giving the bank of thanks, but he's been called away on an emergency. And so it's fallen down to his dear old dad to do the honours. Yeah. So to all those dads who feel worthless, your time will come. I'm not as eloquent as Stephen, because I don't get the practice. Nobody listens to me at home. Except the cat. And he's got selective hearing. But as you know, this concert is an aid of the Hill and Son organ project, which we're very proud of. Over the years, we've had various people and groups who have given concerts of a very high caliber, concerts that we have enjoyed. And this afternoon is no exception. What a great way to spend a cold afternoon inside listening to the warmth and the enthusiasm of a group of singers as we've had today. Do keep up the good work. Keep giving joy to people who listen to you. And look, would everybody stand up and just give them an ovation and show out.